Welcome class 7. Today we will start with the new chapter, Rational Numbers. We have learned earlier that natural number starts from 1 and moves on like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and it moves on up till infinity. So natural number, the smallest number is 1. And the biggest number is infinity. Similarly, whole number, the whole number has a number extra than the natural number, that is 0. So whole number starts from 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, and it moves on. Like natural number, it moves up till infinity. So the smallest number in case of whole number is 0. Then we have the integers. Integers like the whole numbers have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and it moves on up till the positive infinity. As well as it has the negative numbers also like minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. And then it also again moves towards left towards the minus infinity. Then we have the rational numbers. The rational numbers are of the format P by Q. Okay, where P is the numerator and the Q is the denominator. Now, P can be any integer. It can be minus 1, minus 100 or plus 2, 500, whatever. Okay, P can have any value. Okay, it can be minus as well as plus integers. And Q also can be of any value, but Q should not be equal to 0. If Q becomes equal to 0, then this rational number will not be the rational number. So Q, the denominator, should not be equal to 0. For example, we can say like 7 by any number 13 is a rational number, or 4 by minus 17 is also a rational number. But if you have any number like 5 in the numerator and 0 in the denominator, then this number is not a rational number because you cannot have 0 as the denominator. Now if you take any integer like minus 3, okay. So, minus 3 is an integer, but if it has to be represented as the rational number format, that is P by Q, then minus 3 can be written as minus 3 in the numerator by 1 in the denominator. So, minus 3 by 1 becomes the P by Q format, which again becomes the rational number. So, an integer can also be represented as a rational number. So we can say every integer is a rational number. Okay, but every rational number cannot be the integer. So every integer is a rational number. But every rational number cannot be integer. For example, if I write a rational number like 3 by 2, then 3 by 2 is not an integer. So, it's not an integer. So, this is wrong. Because 3 by 2, if you calculate, it will be equal to 1.5. And 1.5 is not an integer. Similarly, a whole number like 0 can also be written as 0 by 1, which is a rational number format P by Q. So, a whole number also can be written as the rational number. So, we can say every whole number is a rational number. So, every whole number is a rational number. But every rational number again is not a whole number. Just like every integer is not a rational number. Sorry, every rational number is not an integer. Similarly, every rational number is not a whole number, but every whole number is a rational number. Likewise, every natural number is a rational number, But again, every rational number is not a natural number. For example, here we have 5 by 8, which is a rational number. But if we say that it's a natural number, then it is wrong. Because 5 by 8 is not a natural number. So now look at exercise 2A. Here, in question number 2, write down the numerator of each of the following rational numbers. So minus 125 by 127. So what is the numerator? It's minus 125. And in question number 2, what is the numerator over here? It's 37. The numerator over here is minus 85 and so on. So this one is very easy. Only you have to write down what is the numerator. So when the number is 2, only 2, then you can write down this number 2 as 2 by 1. So when you write down 2 as 2 by 1, then it becomes a rational number format. Then the numerator is 2. And similarly for 0, write down what will be the numerator. Question number 3 is denominator you have to write for these rational numbers. So in the first one, the rational number minus 15 is the denominator. Here 29 is the denominator and so on. Just like here in question number 2, you found out the numerator. Here you have to find out the denominator. So it's very easy. So have a look at question number 4. Write down a rational number with numerator minus 5 into minus 4 and with this as the denominator. Alright, so here the denominator is 28 minus 27 into 8 minus 5. So let's have a look at the solution for this question number 4. So in the question we have the numerator given as minus 5 into minus 4 and the denominator is 28 minus 27 within the bracket multiplied with 8 minus 5. So here minus 5 into minus 4 means 5 into 4 is 20 and minus into minus is plus. So the numerator is 20, okay, and denominator is 28 minus 27 is equal to 1 multiplied with 8 minus 5 is 3. So 1 into 3 is 3. Therefore the required rational number we can write down as P by Q. The required rational number where the numerator is 20 and the denominator is 3. We have got 20 by 3. You can write down the answer as 20 by 3, or since it's an improper fraction, we can convert it as a mixed fraction. So 3, 6, 18. Okay, we have the 2 as a remainder. So 2 is the remainder and 3 as the denominator. 6, 2 by 3 becomes the required rational number. Even the mixed fraction is also the rational number. So you can write it as a mixed fraction. Next, in question number 5, we can see minus 15 by 1 is a rational number in integer form. That means we have to write if this number minus 15 by 1 has to be written in integer form, then what will be the answer? So this number in integer form is dash. So what is minus 15 by 1? Minus 15 by 1 is minus 15. So over here, you can write down minus 15 as the answer for this question. So minus 15 becomes the answer over here. And so on, you can do these questions from question number 5. So up till question number 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, you can try it as your homework.